there is a posting on YouTube now. The title of it is Why No Looting in Japan After Tsunami and Earthquake of 2011. And in that posting on YouTube, they've taken some clips of a message I preached in 2005 after the Katrina event, pointing up the barbarism, the animal behavior of black men in a time of crisis by raping, by robbing, by fighting, by looting. Also after the 2009 earthquake in Haiti, the Haitian men, the black men, were robbing and looting and raping. In the wake of that tragic event, what black men are inescapable, they cannot do anything else but become barbaric. That when those people went into that dome, those black women and children and black men, there should have been organization. The black men should have set up posts to secure food, to protect the people. The black pastors, and many of them were very prominent, with 20 and 25,000 members. They, of course, were able to get on their private jets and hightail it out of town and did not come back or didn't think about trying to help their members who had bought those private jets for them and paid for all of their living. They left town as quickly as they possibly could when the flood waters began to rise. I was not down there telling those black men to act like animals, to rape those girls, to take all the food, and to stink up that dome with feces all over where the bathrooms backed up, and just a nightmare they created for one another. Because when you leave black people unto themselves, that's how they act. Pastors who should have been there trying to heal, trying to comfort, trying to give some sort of direction to all of that, what was going on in the midst of Katrina, were hightailing it out of town on their private jets and taking the top floor of the Marriott Hotel in Atlanta and the Marriott's and the other fancy hotels in Dallas, Florida, while they're sitting up in these fancy suites and flying around in their private jets and had their Rolls Royces and Bentleys flown to Dallas and Atlanta so they could ride around in their Bentleys while they were there. This is the nature of the black man. This is his true unabashed nature. When he is left to himself, when the cavalry didn't come, when FEMA did not respond in the wake of the Katrina breaking of the levees, the black people set up a nation of killing one another because that's who they are and they can't do anything other than that. Whether they are pastors with large amounts of monies or doctors with PhD or medical degrees, they cannot have a civilized unity of nation among themselves. And so that's why when they were left to themselves, the cavalry wasn't there, even the police began to loot and rape and rob and shoot and maim black people. And when the helicopter came finally after days of struggling in that dome, the black men were beating the women trying to get on the helicopter, and the police had to pull their guns on the men and say the women and children first. This is the unabashed nature of black people. You get angry with me because I will not walk lockstep with the lie that black leaders and bleeding heart liberal white leaders tell about black people. I speak the truth about black people. It isn't because I hate them. If somebody don't tell the truth, they're only gonna get worse. Now, I want you to compare what happened in Katrina and compare what happened in Haiti to what's going on now with the Japanese people, how orderly they are, how considerate they are of one another, how patient they are of one another, how they are responding to a disaster far worse than Katrina. Idea, you don't see looting. There is not one report of looting, of raping, or inhumanity towards man of the Japanese people one towards another. But I guarantee you, if it happens in a black neighborhood, black people turn on each other like dogs in the night. It is, and that is the the black man can't do any better. He doesn't have the spiritual strength to do any better other than to turn on his own, to destroy, to rob, to rape, and to maim. He doesn't have any other strength. He doesn't have the integrity, the honesty to lift himself up. Is it because the black man hates the white man that he in turn hates his own kind? What is it that this happens? Why is it that what have the Japanese people, what do they know about unity and humanity? What do they know about struggle and survival? What do they know that the black man doesn't know? Now, don't hate me for this. Why? Why do you hate the truth? Why can't black leaders admit that we are barbarous, animalistic, maniacal, helpless people? We can't do anything except destroy. We can't build. We cannot. The only thing we can do is destroy. No president, black nor white, can solve our problems. We've got something internally in our blood worse than sickle cell that causes us to attack one another. Why do you hate me? Why do you hate me? Because I speak the truth. Look at the death of what's happening. Look at what's going on all around you. Look at the death, the suffering, the poverty, the brokenness. And you want to continue that? Perchance the reason why you can't love what I say is because you are an animal and you don't respond in the human species culture of human relations one to the other. You are an animal. That's why you hate what I say.